Hello everyone, this is the third revision video for the chapter of triangles. In the first one, I told you about the basic proportionality theorem. Second one helped you revise the similarity criteria and the questions related to it. This one is for the ratio of the areas of similar triangles. Now we have theorem 6.6 in our books. The ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. Now this again is a very important result. Though the proof is not in syllabus for the year 2021, but yes, its application can very well be asked. So just understand the result. In case ABC triangle is being given similar to triangle PQR, okay, then what will I get? Then the ratio of the areas of triangle ABC to area of PQR will be equal to square of the ratio of the corresponding side. That means AB upon PQ square. It can also be equal to BC upon 2R square. It is also equal to AC upon PR square. Again, the proof is not there, but yes, statement is important because it is used in many questions. Now, let us draw up some examples and questions related to this theorem now. Let us take a very important example. We are taking up example 9. In the given figure, this line XY is parallel to the line AC and it divides a triangle into two parts of equal areas. That means area of triangle BXY will be equal to area of AXYC. I need to find out the ratio of AX upon AB. This is what I need to find out. Now, I'll be using the theorem what we had done before, that the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to square of the ratio of the corresponding sides. For that, first thing is that I need to prove the triangle similar. So what I do is I'll prove triangle XBY similar to triangle ABC. Very easily I can do that. I can prove them similar by using the parallel lines. Since XY is parallel to AC, therefore angle X will be equal to angle A and angle B is the common angle. Therefore, by the AA rule of similarity, prove triangle BXBY similar to triangle ABC. Now, it is given to me area of AXYC is equal to area of BXY. Now, they are the part of the same triangle. So, that means area of this triangle will be equal to half of area of ABC. Right? Now, once I've got that, area of ABC is equal to twice of area of BXY, or area of ABC upon area of XBY is equal to 2. This is the first important result I get, and I mark it as equation 1. Once I have got this, I know that the triangles, I've just now proved them similar by the AA rule of similarity. So I know that if triangle ABC is similar to triangle XBY, then area of ABC to area of XBY will be equal to AB upon XB whole square. That means I have got AB upon XB whole square is equal to 2:1. That means AB upon XB will be equal to root 2 if I take the square root of both sides. Once I get that, I just take the reciprocal and I get XB upon AB is equal to 1 upon root 2. That means that if I subtract this from 1 from both sides, I get 1 minus XB upon AB is equal to 1 minus 1 upon root 2, which simplifies to give me AB minus XB upon AB is equal to root 2 minus 1 upon root 2. What is AB minus XB? It is equal to AX upon AB is equal to root 2 minus 1 upon root 2. That is what I wanted to find, but I will not leave the answer in the denominator, so I'll rationalize it. And I get AX upon AB is equal to 2 minus root 2 upon 2. So my dear children, I hope you have understood this example. It's a very important example. Let us take up the second question of exercise 6.4. Diagonals of the trapezium ABCD with AB parallel to DC intersect each other at point O. If AB is equal to twice of CD, find the ratio of the areas of triangle AOB to triangle COD. Now, what is given to us? It is given to us that ABCD is a trapezium, AB is parallel to DC, and AB is twice of CD. I need to find out the ratio of the areas of triangle AOB to area of COD. Clearly, this triangle AOB is similar to triangle COD or not? Why? This angle equal to this angle, 3 equal to 4, vertically opposite angles, 1 equal to 2.
Interior alternate angles.
Therefore, I can say that the triangles are going to be similar. If the triangles are similar, what do I know? I know that the ratio of their areas is equal to ratio of the square of the corresponding sides. That means AB square upon CD square, which is equal to what? It is equal to 4 upon 1 is the answer. The third question now. In the figure, ABC and DBC are two triangles in the same base BC. If AD intersects BC at O, show that area of ABC to area of DBC is equal to AO upon DO. Just see, it is a simple question. See the figure. It's given to me that these are two triangles on the same base. If AD intersects BC at O, I need to show that area of ABC to area of DBC is equal to AO upon DO. I make a construction here. I draw altitudes AL and DM from A to BC and from D to BC. Can you see this triangle ALO? Is it similar to triangle DMO? Yes, this is 90-90 and these are the two vertically opposite angles. Therefore, the two triangles become similar. If the two triangles are similar, then I'll get AL upon DM will be equal to AO upon DO. So I've got one important equation that AL upon DM is equal to AO upon DO. Remember that I need to find out area of ABC upon area of DBC. Area of ABC will be equal to half into base ABC into the altitude AL. Similarly, area of DBC will be equal to half into base BC into the altitude DM. So I get that area of ABC to DBC will come out to be AL upon DM. Now, AL upon DM I proved equal to just now AO upon OD by the AA rule of similarity, and hence I get that area of ABC to area of DBC is equal to AO upon DO. Hope you have understood. Let us take up the sixth question of exercise 6.4. See what is given to us. It says that prove that the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of the corresponding medians. That means that we are given two triangles ABC and triangle PQR such that they are similar to each other, and I need to prove that the ratio of the area of triangle ABC to area of triangle PQR is equal to AL square upon PM square. Now I'll take up the two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle PQR. In these two triangles, because the triangles are similar, what all do I have? I have angle A complete will be equal to angle P. I'll have angle B is equal to angle Q. I'll have angle C is equal to angle R. And I'll also have the side AB upon PQ will be equal to BC upon QR will be equal to AC upon PR. Use the relationship of the sides. AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR. This BC is what? This BC is twice of BL. Since AL is the median, so BC is equal to twice of BL. Exactly same way, since PM is the median, QR is equal to twice of QM. So I will use that. And I will get the result that AB upon PQ is equal to BL upon QM. And using that also, angle B is equal to angle Q, again by CPST. Therefore, triangle ABL becomes similar to triangle PQM. Because these two triangles are similar, therefore, by CPST, I will get AB upon PQ will be equal to AL upon PM. Right? The two triangles similar, then the ratio of their areas is equal to what? The ratio of their areas is equal to ratio of the squares of the corresponding sides. That means area of ABC upon PQR was equal to AB square upon PQ square. But AB upon PQ is what? It is equal to AL upon PM. So using that, I get the required result. The ratio of area of ABC to area of PQR is equal to AL square upon PM square. Hope it is clear to you. We're taking up a very important question of exercise 6.4, the seventh question. Prove that the area of an equilateral triangle described on one side of the square is equal to half the area of the equilateral triangle described on one of its sides. That means I have a square ABCD. I'm making an equilateral triangle on one of its sides. BC, I make BLC triangle. And on the diagonal AC, I make triangle AMC. BLC triangle and ACM triangles, they are both similar to each other. Reason being that each angle is equal to 60 degrees. Therefore, the two triangles are similar. Now, I need to prove what? I need to prove that area of BCL is half of the area of ACM. Now, how do we prove that? I will first of all prove that they are similar. So, as I told you, since they are equilateral triangles, they are going to be similar by the AA rule of similarity. Since each angle is of 60 degrees, therefore, I can say that the ratio of their areas will be equal to ratio of the squares of the corresponding sides. That means area of BCL upon area of ACM will be equal to BC square upon AC square. Now, just see triangle ABC. In this triangle, this angle is 90 degree. So, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square by the Pythagoras theorem.
But because ABCD is a square, so AB will be equal to BC. Now, AB square plus BC square can therefore be written as BC square plus BC square, which is equal to AC square by the Pythagoras theorem. So, I get twice BC square will be equal to AC square. And hence, AC will be equal to root 2 times BC.
So, if I use that in this result, I get that area of BCL to area of ACM is equal to BC square upon root 2 times BC square, which is equal to 1 upon 2. And that is what I wanted to prove. So, hence our result is proved. Hope you have understood this one. Thank you.